Now, so we'll talk about anointing.
神父神父跟着我吧。
Now, what is anointing?
我怕不理。
In Isaiah chapter 61, verses 1 to 3,
katika Isaiah 65, nusema kwanza hadi watatu,
it says that the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because the Lord has anointed me.
Kwamba roho Mungu ako juu yangu kwa sababu Mungu ameshanipaka tayari. Tafadhali sikusema tukafunge.
To preach good news to the poor,
ili tuhubiri injili kwa maskini,
and to heal the brokenhearted. And to heal the brokenhearted. And to proclaim liberty to the captives. Now, this final verse talks about the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. And he has, because he has anointed me. So, here it talks about the Holy Spirit being with us. And anoint us to preach the gospel and also to heal the brokenhearted, to set the captive free. So, what does anointing mean? Anointing is the presence of God to bring the ability to serve God and bless people. That the presence of God is not just for enjoyment, but it will enable us to preach the gospel, enable us to change people's life, and bring inner healing, and set them free, and change the whole life. So the anointing is the presence of God to bless us in ministry. Of course, in the process, it will bless us too. And also in Acts chapter 10, there it talks about that the Lord has anointed Jesus with the Holy Spirit and with power. That he will go around in the whole land and to heal and to set people free. So this Bible verse also talk about the anointing of God upon Jesus to give him the power to bless people and set people free. So basically, the anointing comes from the presence of God. It's not from human. It's from his presence. God is good. When God is with people, he'll work miracles. He'll change people's life. The people will feel moving in the heart. The life is changed. That they will follow God. So the anointing of God is very important for all ministry. The anointing of God is necessary for ministry. When people just have had knowledge and not the presence of God, he's just teaching facts. But with the presence of God, the Holy Spirit will move in people's heart. And when people hear the word of God with the anointing, people's heart will be touched to have action, and the people will be set free. So it's very important for us to have anointing. Now, do not think that anointing is just for laying on of hands. We can have anointing when we preach the word of God.
But
when we share, when we lead prayer, when we lay hand on people, when we lead worship, when we play musical instruments, when we counsel people, when we talk to people, when the congregation members care for people, when they have the presence of God, it will draw people to come to God. So it's very important to realize that we need God's presence. Say it together. We need God's presence. We don't just work with words. We need the presence of God that people's hearts are touched. We need the presence of God so that we have ideas from God what to do and how to preach. And how our life is changed. When you have the anointing of the Holy Spirit, people can see gentleness in you, willingness to forgive and to love and care. People can see Jesus in you. So we all need the presence of God. Hallelujah!
Amen.
Do we need the presence of God? Hallelujah!
Amen.
You know, the presence of God comes from a continual relationship with God. It's not just sometime praying to God. It's a continual relationship with God. In 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 5 to 10, and this is very important Bible passage that you can go home and read this passage. Here it talks about Samuel has anointed Saul to be the first king of Israel. And then he told Saul to go to a group of prophets. And then he said, when you go there, you will be changed to a new person. Okay, now I'm just briefly explaining the passage and you can explain the idea. It starts with 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 5 to 10, verse 10. So Samuel told Saul to go to a hill of God, and then there he will meet a group of prophets. And they will be praising God. They will be playing different instruments, string instrument, tambourine, a flute, and a harp. And then they will be prophesying. And then the Spirit of the Lord will come upon you, Saul, and then you will prophesy with them also. And you will be turned to another man. And then let this sign come to you that you do as occasion demands, for God is with you. That in the occasion, God is with you.
Hello. Kwamba Samuel anamwambia Sauli kwamba aende mlimani, akaenda atapata watu wa kikundi cha manabii ambao watakuwa wanamtukuza Mungu, na pale ataweza pia kutabiri, ataweza kugeuzwa na kuwa kiumbe kipya.
And then in verse 9 it says that God will give you a new heart.
Katika mstari wa 9 anasema kwamba Mungu atakupatia moyo pia tofauti.
And then the Spirit of the Lord came upon Saul and he prophesied.
Roho wa Mungu akakuja juu ya Sauli na akaweza kutabiri.
Now, so this passage talk about a group of prophets.
Kwa hivyo ikipengele kinaongea ama ile andiko linanena juu ya kikusanyiko ama kundi la manabii.
And 1 Samuel chapter 9
verses 20 to 24.
Samueli wa kwanza 9 mstari wa 20 na 24.
Okay. Now, these two passages are related.
Kwamba hizi andiko mbili zinahusiana.
The 1 Samuel 19, chapter 19, verses 20 to 24.
Kwa Samueli wa kwanza 19, 20 na 24.
Here it talks about a group of prophets were prophesying. Now it's very sad, after Saul experienced the Holy Spirit, he was jealous of David, and then he tried to kill David. And then when Saul heard that David was with Samuel, with this group of prophets, he sent a servant there to arrest David. But when the servant went there, when he saw the prophets, he was filled with the Holy Spirit and he started prophesying. And then the first servant returned without taking David. And then Saul sent a second servant. And the same thing happened. And Saul sent a third servant. The same thing happened. And then he himself went there. And he also started prophesying. And then he returned without taking David. And he said in this passage that Samuel was overseeing these prophets. So this group of prophets were actually students, the followers of Samuel. Samuel had this way of ministry that he has a group of people that he trained this group of people and they keep praising God. And they were filled with the Holy Spirit. They were prophesying in the Holy Spirit. And then when Saul went there the first time, went to this group of prophets, the presence of God was so strong there, immediately Saul was changed to a new person. And then he started to prophesy. And then later, it's very sad to see that Saul was changed. Then he sent the servants there, but when the place was filled with the presence of God, So when the servant was going there, he also was changed and he was prophesying. So we see that the presence of God was very strong with this group of prophets. And what were they doing? They were praising God continually. They were prophesying in the Spirit continually. Now, does it mean everyone worshiping God will have the same degree of presence of God? It is not necessarily the same. Sometimes you see people worshiping, they just, you know, they worshiping with the mouth, with the action, but not with the hearts. The presence of God has been very strong among some groups in the world. There is a person called Gary Oates, O-A-T-E-S. Yeah, the whole name is Gary, G-A-R-Y.
Jerry Oates.
Gary and then Oates, O-A-T-E-S.
Yeah, Gary Oates.
You can write this down. He has written books. One time he went to Brazil. And then he was in a worship. The worship was very powerful. And then God told him in the middle of the worship, take off your shoes, you are on holy ground. That means the presence of God was very strong there. And then he felt very strange, you know. Everyone's worshiping and you take off the shoes. But he followed that voice. And after he took off his shoes, his spirit was taken up to heaven. Then he went through the tent. And then when he has faith, he kept going up. When he was afraid, he fell down. And then he saw angels up there. And then after he came back, he saw angels behind some people. And he told the minister, I saw angels on this side. And then the minister said, okay, God is going to do something there. And people experience healing. So this is one man who was raised up to the heavenly realm when they worship wholeheartedly together. To worship God is not just singing or dancing. It's learning from the heart to say, God, you're so good. You're so wonderful. I admire you. I love you. It's like a whole person wants to jump. I want to jump to God. My spirit ascends to God. It's something that needs time to build up. Yesterday I demonstrated praying for some people. And you saw that they instantly experienced the Holy Spirit. They did not have to wait. Now, I'm not saying I have very strong anointing. There are people who have much stronger anointing. Because I spend much time writing, I have to write a lot of material. I wish I had more time praying. But I try to pray as much as I can. And any time I have, I will be loving God. Any time I love God, I feel power go through me. I feel the shaking power of God going through me. And I feel the joy of the Lord going through me. And freedom. Now I'm on the way to pursue a stronger presence of God. We all go in this direction. But some people just don't have this motivation. I saw people worship, they just worship in a lazy manner. Oh, when they said, please close your eyes to pray, people will be looking around. And after experience the Holy Spirit, I tell them, keep praying to keep the anointing. Is this hard to say, God, you're so good? I need you, I want you. I want to be in your presence. I want to be changed by you. When you have this continual motivation, then your heart is on God. You know, I have many opportunities, like sometimes I wait in the airport for hours to go transfer. And
kwa muda mrefu.
But I will enjoy the time to pray to God.
Hiyo wakati huwa nafurahia wakati wa kuomba Mungu.
Some people say, what do you say when you pray so long?
It's
not what we say.
It's
to worship in spirit and in truth.
It's
the Holy Spirit. Oh, hallelujah.
Oh,
hallelujah. I don't have to say out loudly.
Sitaki kusinzia, lazima niiseme kwa sauti kuu.
It's from the spirit.
Lakini kutoka kwa roho.
It's also from the heart.
Ambapo kutoka moyoni pia.
God is so good.
Kwa sababu Mungu ni mzuri.
So when you sing,
wakati unaposimba,
you sing with your heart.
Unaimba na moyo wako.
God is so good. Oh. God is so good. In God there is unlimited blessings.
Kwamba katika Mungu baraka zilizo huko hazipunguki.
In God when you enter one door you find more blessings.
Unapoingia tu kwa Mungu unapata baraka nyingi.
More strength.
Unapata nguvu nyingi.
More motivation.
Unapata kuchochewa zaidi.
You enter another door.
Unaingia pale ndani.
Another level.
Katika kiwango kingine.
More blessings.
Baraka nyingi.
I know one person,
najua mtu mmoja,
she spent 3 or 4 hours a day waiting for the Lord.
Kwamba alikuwa anachukua masaa matatu au manne akimngojea Mungu.
She wake up at 4 a.m.
Anaamka saa 10 asubuhi.
Until she pray until 7 a.m.
Anaomba mpaka saa 1 asubuhi.
And she still has a baby to take care of.
Na hapo hapo
alikuwa na mtoto, a young boy.
Alikuwa na mtoto kijana mdogo kushughulikia.
And she waited for the Lord for a long time.
Na anangojea Mungu kwa muda mrefu.
And then God started to take her to heaven.
Na Mungu akaanza kumpeleka mbinguni.
And she saw mysteries in heaven.
Na akaona maajabu kule mbinguni.
Now God opened the way for me to know people like this.
Kwamba Mungu akamfungulia njia kuona watu mara hii.
I did not seek for this, look for this person.
Kwamba sikutafuta mtu huyo.
It is God who, you know, spoke through another minister to ask me to go.
Kwamba ni mtu wa Mungu aliyenenea mtu mtumishi mwingine. Kwamba nikaweza kumwelekeza kwa Mungu.
Actually at that time I did not have the motivation to go.
Kwamba wakati huo sikuwa na uchochezi Mungu wa mwiko Mungu.
But this minister kept telling me, please come, please come.
Na huyo mtumishi aliendelea kuniambia tafadhali njoo, tafadhali njoo.
And then I met this woman minister.
Alafu nikakutana na huyu mwanamke mtumishi wa Mungu.
And then she told me how she prays and then she goes to heaven every day.
Na akaniambia jinsi anapoomba anaenda mbinguni kila siku.
That God reveals to her mysteries.
Na Mungu akaweza kumuonyesha maajabu.
And also when she's in a place like in a room like this,
wakati anapokuwa mahali katika nyumba kama hii,
she would be able to sense the spirit of each person.
Kwamba ataweza kuhisi roho ya kila mtu.
That she's in the strong presence of God. She can feel the spirit of the people.
Anaweza kuhisi roho ya watu.
I'm telling you, there are people who enter a strong, strong presence of God.
Nakwambia kuna watu ambao katika uwepo mzito sana wa Mungu.
I have only gone a certain distance.
Nimeenda tu kwa hatua fulani.
I have a long way to go.
Bado niko na safari ndefu ya kwenda.
But I'm telling you, hunger for God.
Lakini nakwambia kuwa na njaa ya Mungu.
Be pleasing, be very happy and appreciative of God.
Kuwa furahia na upungue shukrani kwa shukrani kwa Mungu.
And spend long time praising Him and loving Him.
Na chukua muda mwingi kwa kumsifu na kumwomba.
It's not only the length of time. It's not only the length of time.
Kwamba si tu ile muda mrefu unachukua.
It's how open your heart is.
Ni jinsi unafungua moyo wako kwake.
How much you appreciate God.
Jinsi gani unakumshukuru Mungu.
How much you hunger for God.
Kwamba unamwona
Now some people hear this message, they really say, yes, I want to go deeper into God.
But some people hear this,
they say, oh, so what? I see some of you have excitement in your eyes. But I see some of you just, you know, I say, so what? I hope you know that God is unlimited. If you really love God with all your heart, and also any time, whatever you do, you love God at the same time. Let me tell you, when I'm preaching now, what I'm doing, in my heart, I'm very happy with God. I hunger for God. I want God's presence. I want God to change your heart. So when I'm preaching, I'm connected to God all the time. And that is why I continue to receive message from God. How to teach people. How to train people. I hope you hunger for God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do you hunger for God? Now for some people it might be very difficult. How can you hunger for God? First, you really say God is good. Everything He does is good. His creation is good. His work in our heart is good. His acceptance of us is good. He keep working in our heart even when we are rebellious. Everything He does is good. Heaven is good. And to be with God is wonderful. So when you have this heart, then your heart will really say, God is good. And then you will learn to appreciate God from your heart. And you learn to enjoy God. Now please look at me. When I think of God, my whole person is in comfort. The joy of the Lord and the love of the Lord will fill me. His power will go through my body. And I'm totally free. And I can enjoy God for a long time. Is this hard to do? God, you're so wonderful. God, you're so beautiful. And that's why I really want to talk about God's nature preaching method. How God's nature, how to tell people about the goodness of God. I love to talk about God all day long. Some people I went to in different places, they said, Pastor, you just talk about God all the time. You hear my teaching, I'm always talking about God, how good He is. And how to live in His love. And live in His blessings. And God will bless you with unlimited blessings. Let me tell you, I'm 65 years old.
What should you want me?
I'm healthy and strong. I play tennis.
I
know the different countries. And I'm strong. I don't need eyeglasses. To see small letters. And God gives me the best wife I know. I haven't seen any better wife than my wife. And God has given me wisdom. What I want to say is God will give you those things too. He wants to give you many blessings. If you just follow God totally, God is so good. When you are sweeping the floor, oh Jesus, you're so wonderful. I like you. I worship you. I adore you. I want to be with you. Sometimes you don't have to have words. It's just from the Spirit. You know, Samuel has that close relationship with God. So he trained a group of prophets. And then David went to him and stayed with him for a period of time. And David was changed by Samuel. That is why David has the tabernacle of David. And the Levites will be worshipping 24 hours a day. That is why the Bible talks about to rebuild the tabernacle of David. That people will be worshipping God 24 hours a day. You know, you want your ministry to go a higher level. You want your life to go a higher level. God has the key. God's presence will give that to you. When you stay in God's presence, you'll have unlimited blessings. So the first thing to learn, you'll have an alert spirit. Alert spirit.
Alert.
You know, some people worship God like this. The spirit is not alert. They cannot stay alert. They cannot concentrate. Because the mind is messy. But you can learn to concentrate on the Lord. Anytime you are distracted, immediately you pull yourself back to love God again. And to love God with zeal. With fire and freedom. Then you can enjoy God. You know, some people say, oh, you have to read the Bible, you have to pray. That is using the law. You have to do this, do that, pray, and read the Bible. But I will tell you, the Bible is full of the promises of God. It's full of the beauty of God. And to love God with your heart, you'll be blessed by God. You'll be strengthened by God. So I motivate people to come close to God by telling them how wonderful God is. So people will be motivated by God's love to have a close relationship with them. Now when you hear what I just said, do you feel fire in your heart? If you feel fire, can you raise your hand? If you feel yes, I want to live a life like that. Could you raise your hand? Hallelujah. Now wait. Raise your hand.
How many of you hunger
for God's presence? Would you raise your hand? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God is beautiful. God is wonderful. Hallelujah.
Oh.
So all day long. Every time I think of Jesus, the love and the joy of the Lord will come. Prayer is the most enjoyable time. Okay, now we go to the next passage, Acts chapter 4, 31. In the early church, when they prayed together, the place where they were assembled together was shaken, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and they spoke the word of God with boldness.
Wakati walikuwa pamoja wakiomba, waliweza kujazwa Roho Mtakatifu na wakanena kwa ujasiri.
So here is the strong presence of God when they pray together.
Hapo napata watu ambao wanaomba pamoja.
On the first Pentecost, that on that day, that they were filled with the Holy Spirit.
Kwamba siku ya kwanza ya Pentecost wakajazwa Roho Mtakatifu.
And they were filled with the power of the Holy Spirit, the presence of God.
Na wakati walipojazwa Roho Mtakatifu na uwepo wa Mungu.
And they prayed with fire.
Wakaomba kwa moto.
The place was shaken.
Kwamba hapo mahali pakatetemeka.
And these people were filled with the Holy Spirit.
Na watu walijazwa Roho Mtakatifu.
And they spoke the word of God with boldness.
Na kanena neno la Mungu kwa ujasiri.
So here is an instance of the infilling of the Holy Spirit, the strong presence of God.
Hapa kuna kujazwa Roho Mtakatifu na uwepo mkuu wa Mungu.
And what does it do?
Na lifanya nini?
The people will feel the Holy Spirit.
Hapa watu walijazwa Roho Mtakatifu.
And they have courage.
Na wakakuwa na ujasiri.
To preach the word of God.
Ili kuhubiri neno la Mungu.
Now, I told you about the experienced God evangelism yesterday. How you can have the anointing of the Holy Spirit and pray for people.
I
tell you, there were many people that experienced the Holy Spirit together with me in Hong Kong in 1998. But not everyone hunger for God. When I experience the love of God filling my heart, taking away my burdens, and make me feel so strong in love by God, I said I want to have a very close relationship with God. So I spent a long time praying every day. I also said that the evangelist has that anointing to bless people. I want to be like you too. If someone else can do it, we can do it when we see God. And then I was courageous to pray for people. And I was courageous to ask people, have you experienced anything during the prayer? Now many people are not willing to ask people. Many people are not willing to ask people what they experienced in the prayer. Then it's harder to reap the harvest at that point.
Iwe ni vigumu kuleta kuvunja zile vitu vigumu wakati wa kawa ambapo unaogopa kuuliza watu ungeweza kusema jinsi unavyohisi wakati wa maombi.
But when I hear them what they have experienced,
lakini naposikia kile ambacho wamehisi,
I will tell them God has blessed you like this.
Ninawaambia Mungu atakubariki katika hiyo hali.
Do you want God to continue bless you?
Unataka Mungu aendelee kukubariki?
And then I will lead the person to Christ.
Now we tell the kids a move back from the Christ.
And then for Christians, when they experience the Holy Spirit,
what Christ wanna for his room to get.
I will tell them you can carry the power of God to bless people.
Come go now to one people is a book and move the move to be able to watch.
Are you willing to do it?
Wow, give what have for him.
God give me the courage.
Come go be a move to be able to see.
Let me tell you when I experience the Holy Spirit,
what did one be able to see from that.
I was a professor in a traditional seminary.
Kambaye alikuwa mkufunzi katika seminari.
And I prayed, lay hand on all my students.
Na nilikuwa naambia wanafunzi wangu wote.
I was not afraid.
Kambaye naogo.
Because of this boldness, I was able to go into the ministry of the Holy Spirit and the Word of God.
Kwa sababu ya ujasiri wake alikuwa angeingia katika huduma ya neno la Mungu.
There are many times when I pray for people say, I haven't experienced anything.
Kwani vigumu sana wakati naombea watu alafu nauliza wakose waseme kwamba hawajihisi chochote.
But I will say, it doesn't matter.
Baba wanasema haijalishi.
You continue praying.
Endelea kuomba.
You experience God more and more.
Baba utaweza kuhisi Mungu zaidi na zaidi.
So God just give me the courage.
Baba Mungu nipatie ujasiri.
To do evangelism wherever I go.
Ili nikafanye uinjilisti mara popote nienda.
To pray for people wherever we go.
Niombe
that comes from the Holy Spirit.
You need to get the Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit comes so that we can have courage.
Roho Mtakatifu yaje kwa sababu ndio ili tukaweze kuwa na ujasiri
and have wisdom and have power.
Na kutakuwa tupenda hekima na nguvu.
Then your ministry and your life will never be the same again.
Alafu huduma yako na maisha yako hayataweza kusalia vile vile.
And also leading worship too.
Na pia ikuelekeza katika kuabudu.
You know, when I lead worship some people see angels.
Wakati ninapoongoza kuabudu, wengine wanaona malaika.
When I enter the strong presence of God,
wakati ninapoingia katika uwepo mkuu wa Mungu,
and lead people into the strong presence of God,
na niongoze watu katika uwepo mkuu wa Mungu,
people's life will be changed.
Maisha yote yanabadilishwa.
It's not just singing.
Sio tu kuimba.
I'm saying you can do it too.
Nasema pia wewe unaweza fanya hivyo.
It's not just for some people.
Sio tu kwa watu wengine.
It's for everyone.
Ni ya kila mtu.
Can you say to the person next to you, you can have the strong anointing of the Holy Spirit.
Ambejana kwa kwamba unaweza kuwa na upako mkuu wa Roho Mtakatifu.
You can be used by God greatly.
Kwamba unaweza tumikia na Mungu kwa ukuu.
Can you say to yourself,
ebujiambie mwenyewe,
yes, my life can be raised to a high level.
Kwamba maisha yako inaweza inuliwa kiwango cha juu.
You know, with people, we cannot do it. We cannot change ourselves. But God has the ability to give you that change in your life.
Lakini Mungu ana uwezo wa kubadilisha mabadiliko katika maisha yako.
If you say, yes, I want change.
Ukisema ndio nataka mabadiliko.
I want growth.
Nataka kukua.
The key is not just to learn.
Kwamba funguo si tu kujifunza.
The key is the relationship with God.
Ufungue ni uhusiano wako na Mungu.
But of course you need to learn too.
Lakini lazima ujifunze pia.
But the two is more important to have the connection with God.
Lakini muhimu ni kuwa na uhusiano mzuri na Mungu.
And then you need to learn.
Na ndipo ujifunze.
And God will also teach you.
Na Mungu atakufundisha.
God continue to speak to me.
Mungu ataendelea kuonana nami.
And he'll speak to you too.
Na atakutendea.
He will put fire in you.
Ataweza kuingia ndani yako.
You want it?
Unamhitaji?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh. And the ministry will become very easy.
Na huduma itakuwa rahisi sana.
And relaxing.
Na itakuwa tu ya kutulia.
Acts chapter 5 verse 15 to 16.
Matendo ya Mitume 5 mstari wa 15 hadi 16.
And then people brought the sick people to the streets and laid them on beds and mats so that at least Peter's shadow might fall on them on Sunday as he passed by. And then in verse 16, And there are many people coming from the surrounding cities, bringing the sick and those tormented by evil spirit, and all of them were healed.
Alafu watu wakaleta watu wengi barabarani wakiwalaza katika mikeka na vitanda ili Petero anapopita kivuli chake kiweze kuwaguza. Wengine wakaletwa na wale ambao waliteswa na mapepo, lakini wote waliweza kuponywa kupitia kivuli cha Petero.
Now Peter talks about a strong presence of God around Peter. Like I demonstrated yesterday, before I prayed for the person, the person already felt the power of God. You know, for 1.5 years, I have a prayer group every morning, every day, and then
you
practice, you know, praying to God. And practice how to have a strong anointing of God. And we try different ways how to open our heart to God. And I found that when we open our heart, people can feel the power of God in the distance. Let me share with you one experience. I went to a church to train anointing. And then there were two of us praying together. And then to build up a strong presence of God. And then there was a third person. And I told the third person to come up and feel the presence of God. But the person, instead of walking, she ran up to us. When she ran to us, she felt a great power. And she was bounced back and fell on the floor. She was not entering the power. She was bounced back by the power and fell on the floor. And then they experienced great love or joy or peace. The presence of God can be tangible. You can feel the presence of God. I hope you're hungry for God. Not for manifestation. Not for manifestation, the showing the signs of the Holy Spirit, but for a strong presence of God, so you'll be changed by God, so that you will have the strong presence of God to bless people. So I hope you're hungry for that. And every time you pray or worship, you worship with all your heart. Now, as I said yesterday, you can distinguish the spirit and the soul. The soul has three functions. Please write this down. The mind, the will, and the feelings. The mind, the will, and the feelings.
Hisia, upendo, na mawazo.
Okay. That means, first your mind will say, God is the best. Everything in the Bible is the best. And then the next is, you say, Lord, I give my whole life to you. And then the feelings, oh, when I hear about God, I love God.
And on a Sunday afternoon, another priest and I go come by. You talk to me now.
Whatever I do, I think of God.
But I feel like what you're not fine. I'm not fine. I'm not
fine. Even when I drink water,
I don't know what you're imagining.
Water tastes good.
Come back, Maji. You have to let that down.
Even when you relax and take deep breaths. Try it now.
autulie, ukavute pumzi ndani.
It feels good.
Alafu funga tu macho.
Try it now. Deep breath. Relax.
Tafadhali nasema tulia, funga macho yako, vuta pumzi ndani. Unahisi vipi?
And when you eat, do you like the food?
Na wakati unapokula, unapenda chakula?
It's all designed by God with love.
Kwamba yote imeundwa na Mungu kwa upendo wake.
God is full of
love.
I told you about my wife.
Nikawaambia juu ya mke wangu.
She's so good.
Kwamba yeye ni mzuri zaidi. Wewe mwenye upendo mke wako shauri yako.
But God is billions and billions of times better than my wife.
Na Mungu akwenda aliye ni mzuri zaidi kuliko mke wako mara dufu au mara nyingi zaidi.
So this is the pictures on my calendar.
These are the pictures of yeye na mke wake.
So what I'm saying is, if someone on earth is nice to you,
kama mtu ni mzuri kwako,
you would say, that's wonderful.
Unasema, hey, hii ni ajabu.
But there is one in heaven who is so nice to you.
Na kuna mwingine ni mbinguni ambaye ni mzuri kwako zaidi.
He's better than anyone else in the world.
Yeye ni mzuri zaidi kuliko mtu yeyote hapo ulimwenguni.
Why would you say, I'm so blessed to have God?
Mbona usiseme kwamba nimebarikiwa kuwa na Mungu?
It's so wonderful to have God.
Kwamba ni ajabu kuwa na Mungu.
If you're like that, you will feel the Holy Spirit easily.
Kwamba ukisema au ukitenda hivyo utajazwa na Roho Mtakatifu kwa urahisi.
And then to worship, you know, just now I talk about the soul, the mind, the will, and the feelings.
And kwa sababu nisema juu ya hisia, nafsi na kupenda.
And then our spirit.
Na pia roho yetu.
How to worship in spirit?
Jinsi tunavyokuabudu katika roho.
Psalm 103 verse 1.
Zaburi 103 mstari wa kwanza.
There it says that all that is in me will praise His holy name.
Kwamba kile nasema kwamba chochote kilicho ndani yangu kitalisifu jina lake.
So every part of me, what is inside of me, the spirit inside of me, worship God.
Kwamba kile chochote nafsi na hata mawazo yaliyo ndani yangu yote yakamsifu Bwana.
So worship with the whole person.
Kwa hivyo waabudu na wewe mwenye utu wako wote.
So sometimes I tell people to cry out to God like this.
Watu wengi sasa ngine naomba wote wakamwombe Mungu namna hii.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. From the Holy Spirit. Oh, Jesus. I worship you. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. And you worship with your whole spirit. The presence of God will be stronger, stronger every day.
Now when
you pray, don't say, oh, I have to pray for half an hour, oh, that's difficult. If you think like that, it's difficult.
But you say
it's enjoyable.
Do
you feel comfort to your body when you love God?
Or still to live for more mwilini mwako wakati unapomba Mungu?
Now try it out. Stand up.
Simama tafadhali. Sasa tujaribu kujizia kwa Mungu tukiwa tumetulia, tukiwa na
moyo wa kujitulia.
Na tukifunga moyo wetu zote kwa Mungu.
Jesus in the morning, Jesus at the noontime, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus when the sun goes down. Yes, you in the morning, yes, you at the noontime. you are so good. God is so wonderful. God is so wonderful. I love God. When you do this, you find comfort over your body. You find peace. Relax, close your eyes. Think of Jesus laying his hand on you now. He says, follow me and behind me. He's laying his hand on us. Ooh, think of Jesus in front of you and behind you.
One, two, yes.
And laying his hand on you. And you enjoy God. You find that it is enjoyable. You feel good on your body. And you say, I continue to enjoy God.
Yes.
Think of Jesus in front of you.
One, two, and
it's very different. It's very, very different. It's very, very different. If you think of God in front of you and blessing you, God wants your life to be raised up to a high level. God wants to do great things in your life. Think of God in front of you. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Now try this from your heart. Grace is like talking to God in front of you. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Oh, yes. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Oh, Jesus, Lord, Jesus, Lord, Jesus, Lord. Let me tell you, if you think of Jesus in front of you and expressing your love toward Him, you'll experience something else. I'm filled with the love of God, so strong. Not just to say words. Reach out to God from your heart. Jesus. Jesus, I want you. Raise me to a higher level. Put down all your hindrances. Relax the whole person. I want God. I need you, Lord. Reach out from your heart, you will experience something else. I tell you, any moment you say, Lord, it's so good. And reach out your heart to Him. And it's like singing to Him right in front of you. Many people just sing to the air. You sing to Jesus in front of you. God is so good. God is so experience peace or love or fire, excitement or joy, can you raise your hand?
Kama umehisi uwepo wa Mungu umeweza kuishi kuhisi nguvu za Mungu zinapita ndani yako ukaweza kuinua mkono wako juu.
Those who experience something, raise your hand.
Wale ambao wamehisi kitu tofauti.
Or you feel it's enjoyable, raise your hand.
Ambao unafeel umesumbuka na umefurahia ukaweza kuinua mkono wako.
Can you raise your hand high up if you experience something and... Now I hope you all learn. No. You keep going and keep going. Let me ask you, is there anyone here who wants to share what you experienced just now? Anyone want to come out and share? I hope God gives you wisdom and boldness and courage to share. Okay, anyone want to share? Anyone? Hallelujah.
Nilikuwa nasikia sauti ya Bwana na naona kama niko tu mahali pa jua inawaka, niko katikati ya jua.
She was hearing the voice of the Lord and she felt she was feeling like she's at a place where there is a very big light, like the sun is lightening. The lightening from the sun was very broad.
I was just in the middle of the sun.
She was in the middle of the sun.
So I was just like a person who is sharing the glory of the Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. How does that do anything to your life? Does that do anything to your life?
Yes, I always, if I pray, I always see some visions. And what I need is to be added power.
She wants
a vision of anointing.
One vision of God and then
the anointing.
The anointing.